you ever had someone in your life who just felt more like family? Like maybe it's a close friend or that friend's parent. I remember when I was in high school, I had this friend, Josie, and she was a really, really close friend of mine. But what was really special about our relationship is that I was actually really close with her family. I remember whenever I would go to her house, I would want to talk to her mom because her mom wanted to talk to us about everything that was going on in our lives. And I want to stop here and say this. My family was awesome. I had a great, healthy home life, and I know that more now than I did then. But I remember that I couldn't talk to my parents really about friends or drama at school or boys that I had a crush on. It didn't feel quite safe. But when I went over to Josie's house, I could talk to her mom, and her mom wanted me to call her by her first name. Her name was Eva. So I could talk to Eva about the boys that I liked and the drama that was going on at school, and she felt like one of my friends. And though now I have a great relationship with my mom, I remember thinking then in high school that sometimes I wish my mom was a little bit more like Eva. Has something like this ever happened to you? Like you find yourself comparing your family to other families, whether it's your friends' families or friends or families you see on TikTok or Instagram. Maybe you just really want something different for your family, or maybe you don't feel like you have much of a family to even compare to, so you just find yourself grasping at any other family you can find. See, we all want other people in our lives other than just our family, and none of our families are perfect. And so we need other people in our life. And my question is, what if God could make your family bigger? And I don't mean like your mom has another baby or something, but like what if he could make your family bigger? What if your family and the concept that you have of family could grow? So we're gonna come back to that question, but what we have to do first before we can answer that is look at what the Bible has to say. One thing I love about the Bible is that it doesn't show us families who are just perfect. It shows us people and families who are like really messed up, and God still uses them. So we're going to talk today about two dudes who are like best friends, and they came from crazy families. Their names are David and Jonathan. So let me tell you a little bit about their families. David was the youngest of a bunch of sons, and one day the prophet Samuel comes to David's dad. His name is Jesse, and he says, "Jesse, one of your sons is going to be the king of Israel. Bring them to me." So Jesse's like, cool, he gets all his sons together, but he says, "You know what, David, you're pretty puny, you're the youngest, there's no way it's gonna be you, you don't have to come." So David had this dad who didn't believe in him, and by the way, David became the king of Israel. And then we have Jonathan, and Jonathan came from a pretty crazy family too. His mom was pretty uninvolved, and his dad, his name was Saul, and Saul was nuts. Saul was the king of Israel, but he was super power hungry, and when he found out that David was gonna take his place on the throne, he did everything in his power to kill David. And somehow, from this crazy match, these crazy families, David and Jonathan became best friends. And they shouldn't have been, right? They should have been enemies. David was gonna take the throne, and Jonathan was actually the heir to the throne. But they became friends, and let's see what the Bible describes their friendship as. After David had finished talking with Saul, he met Jonathan, the king's son. There was an immediate bond between them, for Jonathan loved David. And from that day on, Saul kept David with him and wouldn't let him return home. And Jonathan made a solemn pact with David because he loved him as he loved himself. Jonathan sealed the pact by taking off his robe and giving it to David, and together with his tunic, sword, bow, and belt. I love that last verse because I feel like it's basically the biblical equivalent of a pinky swear from two kids on the playground saying they'd always be friends. See, that is how much Jonathan and David loved each other, though they should have been enemies. And here's why I think they loved each other so much and why they needed each other. Because their families were so crazy that they needed someone to stand in the place of their family. They didn't replace their families, but they stood there when the families were not acting like a family should. Actually, one time Jonathan actually saved David's life. In 1 Samuel 19, it says this. Saul now urged his servants and his son Jonathan to assassinate David. But Jonathan, because of his strong affection for David, told him what his father was planning. "Tomorrow morning," he warned him, "you must find a hiding place out in the fields. I'll ask my father to go out there with me, and I'll talk to him about you. And then I'll tell him everything you need to find out." See, Jonathan was everything David needed in a friend. He's everything you would want in a friend. He loved David, he cared about his well-being, and he saw potential for his future in him. And we all need people in our lives like this. We need people who love us through thick and thin. So now we come back to our question. Can God make your family bigger? What would it be like if you allowed other people to serve that family purpose in your life? People in our life who are like family are so important, and I think that's kind of why Jesus started the church. The church isn't just a building, it's all Jesus' followers all over the world, and we're all family because we need other people in order to be emotionally and spiritually healthy people. In Hebrews 10, it says this, "Let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works, and let us not neglect our meeting together, as some people do, but encourage one another, especially now that the day of his return is drawing near." See, guys, we need other people in our life. And one way we're going to do that is tonight we're going to launch our small group. So come to youth group at the church at 6:30 and be a part of a bigger family. See you guys tonight.